far, keeping it quiet. I pull up, you know I be moving. Whipping the four and I'm cruising. The money I'm speaking the flu.
This is the second date update on the 10 with Ramiro, Pebbles, and Melissa, the Get Up Crew.
Hot 96.9.
Second date update made hot by Staples. Staples print and marketing services can help your business turn big ideas into bigger ideas. Staples print and marketing for your business, printing and beyond.
Hi, Doreen.
Hey.
Hi.
What can we do for you?
Well, you can help me find the guy that I've been dating. He's completely disappeared.
Wow. Okay, so then tell us about what happened. Did you go out with him a couple times, just once? What's the deal?
We've been going out a few times. I mean, I feel like I was ready to, you know, kind of ramp it up a little bit, move to the next level. He met my mom. I thought things were good. I don't know what's going on. Suddenly, I can't find him.
Okay, so let's go back to the last time that you guys hung out. What was the situation there?
Well, okay, so right now my mom is living with me.
Yeah.
She's in between places. She didn't like her last roommate. They just had clashes. So anyway, she's staying with me. She's looking for another place.
Okay.
Tucker came over. We were going to go out, but I thought, you know, he met my mom. I thought we were at that point, kind of, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And I haven't heard from him since. I don't know what the deal is.
So you don't think you did anything that might have turned him off?
I mean, it might have turned him off that my mom was with me. I don't know.
She's putting all the blame on anybody but herself. All right, listen, whatever. We'll call him for you next.
Okay, well, wait, let me say, I don't think I did anything. I mean, I thought we were good.
All right, then that's all you got to say. That's all you got to say. You think you nailed it out of the park. Grand slam.
Whoa.
Just hold on. Hold on. Second date update on the 10.
Now back to the second date update on the 10.
With Ramiro, Pebbles, and Melissa, the Get Up Crew.
Hot 96.9.
All right, we just spoke to Doreen. She's been dating this dude, Tucker, and he has completely disappeared. Not even ghosted, just gone. Mm-hmm. There one day, gone, nothing.
It happens.
Yeah, nothing since. And she swears that she did nothing wrong. The last time they hung out, it was all good. So, we're going to try and find this guy right now and see what he has to say. Maybe he has something going on. That's why he hasn't gotten in contact with you.
Did he leave the country? I don't know.
Maybe he left the country. Yes, maybe he's a CIA agent. He's on a mission right now that we don't know about. And he's going to answer the phone and say, I can't. Right now I'm at an undisclosed location. No. Okay, stay quiet.
Hello?
Hello, is this Tucker?
Who's calling?
Oh, we found him. Okay, so Tucker, please, I'm sorry that we're calling you so early in the morning. This is Ramiro, Pebbles, and Melissa. We're calling you from a radio station, Hot 96.9. And the reason we're calling you is because we got your phone number from a young lady who likes you a lot and would love... She wanted us to get in contact with you on her behalf. So can I just tell you why we're calling?
It's real.
So she... It's somebody you know, and I'm going to tell you her name. She has feelings for you, and she wanted us to call you to offer you a date. You and her at the place of your choosing, the date of your choosing, whenever you're free, and you go, we'll pay for the whole thing just to see if you guys hit it off. And like I said, I'm going to tell you her name because you do know who she is. It's not a trick.
Okay, I guess I'm ready.
All right, you ready? Doreen, my friend.
We were cool. Yeah, we went out, and it was okay. But there's just something else that's going on, and there's this thing I'm into, and I was just trying to see if it worked on that situation, and it wasn't going to work to you know, ideally. So I kind of like just dipped out. But
you sound so sketchy right now. I don't even know.
What's going on?
Yeah, he does. You know, it's funny. We were speculating when we were talking to her that you were like a double agent of some sort, and that's what it kind of sounds like right now. What's the deal?
Well, so I mean, I'm gonna tell you this, guys. I'm just gonna tell you straight up, and you know, you can judge or not judge. But so in college, back in college, and this is gonna sound kind of juvenile, but you know, they used to call me Tucker the motherfucker, right?
Wait, excuse me. What?
Oh my god, I love that.
They called you Tucker the motherfucker.
Why?
Yeah, they call me Tucker the mother. Well, because I like to, you know, I'm in the, you know, MILF. I like, you know, I like moms, you know? I mean, I think it like this. I'm going to be there one day, so I just need to get used to what I'm going to be facing.
Okay.
So that's the situation.
That makes sense. So,
and,
wait. So, by what you're saying, it sounds like you were trying to f*** Doreen's mom.
I was, but not anymore, but yeah.
Oh, what do you mean not anymore? What happened? Did she turn you down?
So, I saw the picture on Facebook, thought everything was, what's up? I thought it was good. Went over there, and this lady was a beast. She was like, a monster, out in the back.
Hold on. Stop.
Because God.
Doreen's on the phone right now, Tucker. She heard what you said about her mom.
I'm here. Surprise. Oh, my gosh. Are you kidding me? First of all.
Whoa, wait. Are you on the phone? Oh.
Oh my God.
It had to sink in.
What the mother is that? I'm going out with a guy that just wants
That's
to
a great nickname.
Look, I was just being clear and free on the air. That's what I'm into, and I'm sorry you had to find out like this, but, I guess that's life, and some things you just, you find out the hard way, and guess what? Your mom's as ugly as shit, girl.
Okay.
Is that really necessary?
Listen to me. Talk about you're a piece of
So, let's say that Doreen's mother was attractive. What would the next step be? Would you forget about Doreen and try and get with her mom? Would you try and get with both of them? What would be the next thing?
It would have been something gradual and really smooth. I would have just kind of stopped naturally, and organically stopped talking to Doreen, and then every once in a while showed up, to fix this or, I was just in the area and, blah, 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 kind of thing.
He's got it all figured out, doesn't he?
Mm-mm.
Hey, Tucker, I got a new nickname for you. It's Tucker the Piece of Shit. How does that sound?
That's so original. Look, I tried to f*** your mom. It didn't work out. But are you still around?
I mean,
so do you want to go?
Okay.
Are you down for another date, Tucker?
The offer is off the table, dude.
What? Are you sure? Because he might do it. And you don't have to worry about him banging your mom.
Well, he's not going to be banging anything. Nothing to do with me anymore. I'll tell you that much.
You sure about that?
Tomorrow on the Second Date Update on the 10th.
Oh, Tucker, it's my dude. Tomorrow you're going to find out why you should never overeat on your first date. And we ain't talking about food. Second Date Update on the 10th. At 8:10 tomorrow, you don't want to miss this one. Hot 96.9.